Yeah, over the course of the 90 minutes, obviously, a team of that stature is going to have a lot of possession at home, but it didn't happen for them in the, not in the entirety of the first half, but most of it. We played with a bit more patience. We kept it and came out and went onto the other side of the pitch when we got the opportunity. So, you know, we passed the ball well. The goal we scored was good. We won the ball quite high up the pitch with Jake Livermore. Sliding Solomon in and his finish was a great start for us. And then we found, I didn't think it was under pressure straight away after that. But they started chopping and changing positions. Son went out on the left wing, then he turned up on the right side of the field. So I think we can gain some solace from the fact that the team that played possibly the best game I've seen so far this season against Real Madrid battered them with a certain formation that they started with here, and we're having to change to try and cope with what we were doing. Say again, sorry. I'm not just reacted the way they've prepared. The things that they've been doing in training, they've been very, very good. They were right today. That today, on the back of getting battered by Chelsea, what happened with Tony, and then coming away to Wembley against one of the better teams in this country, it could have been a disaster for us, but we set off really well, kept it going for a long time, and whilst Spurs had a lot of possession, put a lot of crosses in, aside from the goal, I can't remember, and forgive me if I'm wrong, I can't remember an absolute sitter that we got away with that. So towards the end as well, we probably had the best chance with Solomon from that cross, and Hal's strike from 18 yards. I think if that goes 6 foot either side, Lloris would have had a problem with that. Said that to the players, but like, there'll be every team that's in and around that. And at the moment, it doesn't start as a battle. Battle comes when you're in that position. There's not enough games. We've gone down to this position. We were, I think, the second when we were at the start of the season. So it's been a huge fall from grace. But we are where we are, and then you just look and think, well, if the club can stick in another couple of results, good results, then you can go from there upwards really quickly. So we spoke about that in terms of the players. I don't think it's a team that should be faffing about in the relegation spots, but it is, and then we've got to cope with that.
Do you want the job more now than you did at 3 o'clock?
No different. I didn't say anything about what I wanted at 3 o'clock, and it's no different now. I did say, for those people who haven't been to a couple of press conferences I've done in the last 4 days, I did consciously decided 2.5, 3 years ago that if I'm not getting jobs, I'm going travelling, I'm going golfing and stuff like that, that's what I do. But the previous 18 months before that, I was trying to get jobs and it wasn't happening. So this has whetted my appetite again. I enjoyed being on that touchline. I think I'm good at it. There are, I don't know, there's obviously some reason why I'm not working, but it hasn't made any difference to myself in terms of the 90 minutes that we've played today on this job. That's for the board to decide what they're doing. We hear things all the time. The only thing that I can do is just tell you that I was asked Monday morning to take the team in the interim period, and who knows how long an interim period is. So tomorrow they'll be in for recovery. Monday they'll be in for preparation for the Newcastle game, and then we play Newcastle on Tuesday. If I'm involved in that, they'll get my best. If I'm not, fine. There's nothing I can do, and it's not as if I'll be upset about it. I've been in this a long time. The club's probably fortunate in as much as they need somebody to try and steady the ship with what's been happening, and I've taken over 650 games, so it's not as if I'm from the youth team and like using this as a job advert.
Gary, you stuck with the team that Tony had kind of gone with in recent weeks, but you made one big decision with Sam Field replacing Krakowiak.
No, I made two. with Alan Nyon going in at the right side of centre half spot, the idea was I wanted us to get a little bit higher with the team, doing the same things but higher up, to start engaging Tottenham a little bit higher. And in doing so, I wanted them, and it did much better in the first half than it did the second. The pace of Nyon down the right-hand side and the pace of Johnny on the left-hand side. So there were two big decisions. In terms of Sam, I think he's going to have a great future as a footballer. He's got a lot of qualities, and as I say, we've got some players not playing well enough to keep the place week in, week out. Maybe I spoke at the before the game, saying that when you get in this position, any manager, and it's not, you know, things aren't going for you, you've got two choices: keep it the same, or you've got to make changes. And, like, you know, everybody does the same thing. You know, try to get a little bit more by altering this, tweaking that. And the reality is, you know, we played a lot better today than we have been.
Hey,
I thought they were brilliant as well. You know, I know this is a great thing for any way support to come and you know, see their club at Wembley. It's been a long time for them. But from my own point of view, I enjoyed that. I've always had a good rapport for them. I've got all the time in the world for them. And you know, I thought they were really good. You know, the noise was coming from them. The only thing, the noise that I heard from Tottenham most of the time was slaughtering Ben for what they deemed for taking too long. And yet I'm looking, and I didn't think the amount of time Ben was taking was dissimilar to the amount of time Hugo was taking at the other end. So we had to speak about that at half time, that we don't bring the crowd into it, because, you know, with the result, the way it was going, the way our supporters was going, we were doing fine. The last thing we needed was you know, to give them an opportunity to get into it.
Does he have an unfair reputation,
do you think, Foster? I don't know. You'd have to time him and then see if there was actually something. But he was like, you know, he wouldn't be the first goalkeeper to take his time. And you know, because I was criticising him early on when we were 1-0 up. He was going too quickly forward. There was one occasion he nearly put somebody in. So can't have it both ways. But there was no criticism. He's a fantastic goalkeeper and a great lad.
Can I just confirm, Gary, just that we're in London, so you want the job, now
no,
waiting to find out what the situation
is. No, don't confirm that. I've said it makes no difference for me. I've never said I want the job, and I'm not saying it now, so you can't confirm or deny it. I don't want to be rude.
No, I'm
not trying to be rude. But when I've been asked the question, it's always the same stuff when we're in this scenario. I've just said I haven't given it any thought. You know, I didn't apply for jobs for 3 years. I'm put in this position, and we haven't got a manager at the moment. All this caretaker manager and all that, there's no such thing. You know, because it's not the same thing. You're not signing players, you're not moving players on. You know, you can always turn around and say to the players, well, you know, I might not be here for 2 years longer when you come and see me about why you're not playing. When you're the manager, you can't do those things. So I've never said, and I won't say, that I'm interested in a job. If they turn around and somebody else comes in first thing tomorrow morning, fine, I'll just speak to them, tell them I know about the squad and the goings on at the club. And, you know, if the worst comes to the worst, and I don't get offered a job somewhere else, I'll go travelling and playing golf badly again.
Have they not given you the bug back?
Say again?
Have they not given you the bug back?
It has. Yeah, I thought, you know, dealt with that. It's wet in the outside, I've enjoyed it, but I've enjoyed being alongside Tony as well. I've enjoyed, they call it banter nowadays, I don't know what that is, but having a laugh and a natter and you know, just being amongst football people again, I've really enjoyed that. You know, you saw today, Jerry Francis was on the touchline, and you could see the sparkle in his eyes as well. At the age that Jerry's at and the career he's at, he loved it as well today. So it does give you that, and you know, the one thing that it will do is that I've been offered a couple of jobs in the last couple of years, but I'm not going to traipse up and down the country at my age for two dead frogs in the concrete each week. I'll either do it properly or I'll just go travel.
Okay, guys.
I do it all.